Hi everyone, welcome to this getting started tutorial about the Blazor charts of Syncfusion. Just imagine that you would like to compare the monthly sales data of your company to analyze your company's growth. At this moment, visualizing those comparison data in a chart will make you to understand and analyze the comparisons more quickly. So, using the Blazor charts of Syncfusion, I will let you know how to visualize such sales data in the column chart. Although there are 30 plus Syncfusion chart types available to use in Blazor, but now I'm going to use the column chart and explain you on how to enable few of its basic features like legend, tooltip, and data labels. First, I'll start with the Blazor application creation process. For that, I need to make sure whether .NET Core SDK 3.1.2 or later versions are installed in my machine, and I should have Visual Studio Code or Visual Studio 2019 to create a Blazor application. Now, I'm going to create a server-side Blazor app. So, let me open the Visual Studio 2019 first and create a new project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, I will choose Blazor app and click Next to proceed further to continue with the project creation. Here, I will name my project as Blazor Example and click the Create button. Next, I will choose this Blazor Server App option and click this Create button finally to complete the project creation. Now, the project has been created and ready to use. If you want to know more about the Blazor Server App and how to add Syncfusion components to it, then you can listen to the video link that is shown in the above YouTube card. Now, I will tell you the steps to add Blazor charts. To start using the Syncfusion Blazor charts, first I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor NuGet package into my application. For that, I will open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project and choose the Manage NuGet packages. Then, I will search for Syncfusion Blazor in the browser tab and install it into my project. Once the installation gets completed, I will navigate to imports.razor file, and here I need to add Syncfusion Blazor charts namespace to start using the Blazor charts in any of the components available under the pages folder. Next, I will open the startup.cs file, and here I will add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then I will register the Syncfusion Blazor service by calling the method addSyncfusionBlazor within the configure services method. And I should also register the valid license key of the Essential Studio into my application. So let me register trial license key using the register license method. Now everything is configured. So let me proceed to add the Blazor charts. For that, I need to open the index.razor component, and here I will add charts component by replacing the default code. Now, I will run this example by pressing the key F5. So here, you can see the default chart output with two axes, X and Y, with no data points displayed. Next, I will proceed to show you how to add data to the Blazor charts and display it as a column series. To render a column series chart within the index.blazor component, first I need to define chart series collection tag, which is of type array and can contain n number of chart series definitions inside it. Here, I have planned to add a single column series chart, so let me define a single chart series tag with the property type inside the column series collection. For this type property, I will set the chart series type as column, as I'm going to render the column series chart. Now, let me start to populate the data for chart. So, within this code block, I will define a model class sales data with two fields, month and sales value, as I'm going to populate sales data to the chart. Then I will create a list sales of type sales data and assign an array of objects to it. Next, I need to assign the object sales to the data source property and map the data source fields month to x name and sales value to y name property of the chart series. Here, I have used the categorized data for x axis. So, let me customize the x axis value as category to display the month values in the x axis. To customize the x axis, first I will define chart primary x axis tag and set the value type property as category. So now you can see the column series chart displaying the month values at x axis and sales value at y axis. Here I'm going to show you how to set titles for chart and axis. To set the title for chart, I need to define the property title and set its value as monthly sales analysis within the Blazor chart code. As I said before, x-axis depicts month value, therefore I will set the x-axis title as month. And for y-axis, first I will define chart primary y-axis tag and set the title as sales in dollars, as y-axis depicts sales values in dollars. So here you can see the column series chart displaying the main title as monthly sales analysis. You can also notice that x-axis shows the title as month and y-axis as sales in dollars. Now, let me proceed to show you how to add data labels for chart to display the information about the data points. To add data labels, first I need to define chart data label tag inside the chart marker tag. Then, I will set the visible property as true to display the data point information in the chart. And now you can see the column series chart displaying the data labels for every data points. Alright, now I'm going to show you how to add legend to the Blazor charts. Legend is a piece of information about the series in the chart. So, to add the legend, first I need to define chart legend settings tag inside the Blazor chart code. Then, I also need to set its visible property as true. Along with this, I will set the chart series name as sales to show it as a label for those legend items. And here, you can see the column series chart displaying the legend. Also, you can even collapse or expand the series of the chart by clicking on them. Finally, I'm going to show you how to make the Blazor charts more interactive by adding tooltips to it. To add tooltips to the chart, first I need to define chart tooltip settings tag within the Blazor chart code. Then, to enable the tooltip, I will define the property enable and set its value as true. See the output with tooltip shown for every data point in the chart. Now, let me make a quick summary of what we have seen so far. We have seen how to create a Blazor project using Visual Studio 2019 and add a Syncfusion Blazor chart in a server-side application. Also, we have seen how to render a column series chart with its basic features like legend, data label, and tooltip. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link which is shared in the description part below. You can also grab your chance of getting a free license key to use a complete Blazor products if you fit into a community guidelines. So, check the link given in the description part to know if you are eligible for using a community license. Also, if you find this video as useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching this video.